Hello, my name is Naina Ndukwe, and I'm a developer advocate at Unleash. Today I'm going to walk you through how to implement feature flags in Java using Unleash. We're going to use a very simple Spring Boot example application and toggle a feature flag on and off by creating a feature flag in Unleash and using the Unleash Java client SDK and connecting that to our example app. And we'll get started and follow along using the written documentation that you can find, the tutorial, it's in our docs. And let's get started. The first thing to do is clone the Unleash repo. I already have it on my local machine, so I'm going to cd unleash right into the repo and run the command docker compose up dash d. This should get the containers started. The local instance of Unleash will be running at localhost 4242, and it's popping up here. We'll use the username admin and the password unleash for all. That's the number 4. And now we have the default project that we're in with our local running instance. And we can create a feature flag from here by clicking on New Feature Toggle. The name of the flag will be Endpoint Flag. We won't need to make any changes here. We can create the feature toggle. Now that we've got our flag, endpoint flag, we can enable this in the development environment by switching this toggle on. And the next thing we'll do is go and create an API token. And this is what we'll use in our example application to talk to Unleash and start using our feature flag. We'll go to Settings and then API Access, create a new API token, and I'll name this Java App to keep it simple, Java-App. This will be a server-side SDK. And create the token. We'll copy and paste this token later once we take a look at our example application and connect it to Unleash. So now our API access token has been created. The next thing we'll do is add Unleash to our Java app. I already have the application pulled up here. But what you'll do is want to clone the Spring Boot Java example application. But if you were to clone it, you can use the command git clone like this. And that should get you up and running. But I'm already in the repo right now. And by the way, all of these commands can be found in our documentation, which makes it super easy to follow along this. You can copy and paste this right into your terminal and get things up and running. But next, we're going to use Apache Maven commands to convert our Java source code into jar files, and then we'll be able to execute them. You won't need to have Maven installed for this in order to run the clean package command. I'm going to copy and paste the command here and let it do its thing. Now it's time to add the Unleash Java SDK to our dependencies so the app can initialize the Unleash client and use the feature flag that we just created. And the way to do that is to go to, first of all, open up your code editor. I'm using VS Code here. And go to our palm.xml file and add the dependency on line 82. Let's add this right at the bottom of our list of dependencies. About this. Now that we've got our Unleash Java SDK as a dependency in our palm.xml file, we can move over to our example app.java file. This is where our example app class is. where the Spring app runs in the main function, and we'll need to import the Java SDK into this file. And there's three import lines to use, and you can copy and paste that from the documentation. That's where I'm grabbing it from. Default unleash, unleash in, unleash config. And that's the next thing that we'll get to, is we need to set up the configuration to use the app name, the unleash API, and our API key, so we can initialize it here in this Spring Boot Java example app and get it running, talking to unleash, start using feature flags. So I'm going to go into the main function and right inside, copying and pasting the configuration. And one thing to note here, I think if you're running Docker, you'll need to be able to talk outside of the containers. And in order to do that, you need to change the API from localhost to host.internal, or maybe host.docker.internal, : 4242/API. And that should work, but if it breaks, then might have to modify that URL. We'll double check that. And the API key is the one that we just created in our unleash instance. Going back to unleash, and I can copy the token from our Java app here and use that here. It's pretty simple, pretty straightforward. The next thing I'll do is run the Docker container. And that command is make dist image run. And if I go to localhost 8080/actuator health, and I have a pretty print, that's nice. This looks good. Looks like it's running. So next thing we'll do is we will log the feature flag status in the application. We're staying in the example app file, and within this same main function, we'll use a new line and copy and paste this conditional logic right here. What this will do is check if the flag that we just created, the endpoint flag, is enabled. We'll log the status that it's enabled. And if it's not, we will log the status that it's off. I am getting an unhandled exception. Type interrupted exception error here, so I might have to modify this right here, throws interrupted exception, and see if it plays nice with that. And let's kill that and run it again, just to double check. And there we go. We can see the status being logged here. Endpoint flag is enabled. So this is telling us that the app is happy. First of all, it's talking to unleash, recognizes that the flag is enabled, and now you can run off and do things, interesting things with it. We can verify that the toggle, once you toggle the flag off, that the status will change. And one of the easiest ways to do that is by going into unleash again and turning off the flag in the development environment. This might take a second to propagate, but you'll see eventually, as you can see here in the terminal, that the status has changed, and now it immediately recognizes the flag is off, and so another part of the conditional logic will be executed. And that is the simple, straightforward way to use a feature flag in Java and to use our Java SDK. And that is all. Thank you guys for watching. Like I said, my name is Naina, dev advocate at Unleash, and I'll see y'all again.